In this video, we'll take a look at how to use the border layout. Creating these videos takes a lot of time and effort, so if you want to show me your appreciation, you can subscribe to my channel below. And if you like this type of content, you can also like this video. So what exactly is the border layout? The definition of the border layout is as follows. A border layout lays out a container, arranging and resizing its components to fit in five regions: north, south, east, west, and center. Visually, the border layout will divide the container into five different regions as you see on the screen. So in the top, you see you have the north region. And on the left, you're going to have this west region. And on the right, east. And then bottom is the south. And finally, the center region. Now, it's also important to know that the border layout also supports relative positioning. And that can sometimes be called on the north, can also use this constant called page start. Right, and on the south, it will be called page end. The west we'll call line start. And line end will be for the east. So sometimes the GUI builder will use these constants instead of using the north, west, east, or south. So it's important to recognize how these two different constants can represent the same region in the border layout. The border layout will use the preferred size of the component in that region to determine the dimensions of that region. So in the north, the region will be determined by that component's preferred size, but it will not use the full preferred size. So for the north region, it will only use the component's preferred size height. Right, so it will get the preferred size of that component, and then from there it will extract the height, the preferred height, and only use that that value to lay out the component's height. So in this case, it will only use the preferred height. Now, the border layout will stretch this component to fill the width of the container. Right. And this is this true for the south, where the preferred height of the component will be used. And it will stretch the south component to fill the width of the container. For the west and east regions, it will use the preferred width. But it will stretch those two components to fill the remaining height that's left over from subtracting the preferred size of the north and south. The center will not respect the preferred size. It will stretch the center component to fill all the remaining space that's left. Right? The remaining space for the width will be whatever is left from subtracting the container size from the west and east preferred width. And likewise, the center height will be whatever is remaining from subtracting the container's height from the north and south prefer height. All right, so just know that the center dimensions will be stretched to fill the remaining region. So let's go ahead and create a project that will demonstrate the border layout. Okay, so at this point we finish our project, and if we go look at the preview design, we can see that here is the border layout working. And if you were to resize the container, you can see how these components will stretch. Okay, now again, The size of the north and south components are determined by the preferred size. Actually, all of the north, west, east, and south components along the border are all determined by their preferred size. So if I was to increase the preferred size, you can see how that affects the layout. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the prefer height of the north component. So I'm going to select the north component and navigate to the prefer size property. And I'm going to change the height to be 200 so you can see an exaggeration of that size. Okay, so now if I go and do the preview, you can see that the north component dominates most of that space. So as I resize the container, you can see that the height of the north component is unchanged while the width is always stretched. I can do the same for the west component. So if I were to change the preferred size. So again, with the west component, the height is not respected from the preferred size, but the width is. So if I change the width to be 200, you can see that the west component will use that width. Okay, so that's the demonstration of how to use the preferred size to determine the component size that you desire. So one thing to note is that to set the layout on the NetBeans GUI builder, you have to select the component and right click and go to set layout and choose the border layout in this case. Okay, so now let's take a look at the source code that is generated by the NetBeans GUI builder. The first thing you're going to notice is that it doesn't set the layout manager, and that is because in the JFrame, the default layout manager is the border layout manager. The next thing you'll notice is that when it adds the components to the container, which in this case is the JFrame, it uses these constants, the center constant. You also have the page start, page end, the line start, and the line end. So As I mentioned earlier, these are relative positioning constants, and these are the same as if you were to use north, right, south, west, and east. So just recognize that these sets are the same or pointing to the same region. Creating these videos takes a lot of time and effort. So if you want to show me your appreciation, you can subscribe to my channel below. And if you like this type of content, you can also like this video.